As Jane Nalunga, the executive director of Siatin Uganda, addressed stakeholders, her message was clear. There is still a need to strengthen the country's investment code to ensure that the gaps, especially in human rights, are bridged.
Protect the rights of the people. So we are also looking at the obligation and rights of the government. And we are also looking at the rights and obligations, the rights of the environment. So it's a win-win situation which we want. The investors, we the people as workers, government, communities, and the environment. And how do we do that? We do that by ensuring that our legal frameworks.
According to Penny Nambabazi, the program officer, Data and Aid at Siatin Uganda, there must be alternative proposals and investor obligations need to be addressed to ensure that the mandate of Uganda Investment Authority can be addressed.
We know that perhaps there could be other alternatives that we can give. For example, creating guiding principles for investors to do business here. If it is not their role to regulate, there is need for us to come up with alternative proposals that can ensure that they also get some mandate to be able to do this.
Again, there are some other communities that have not accessed it. So the biggest challenge now is access to the grid. The generation, we even have extra power, what we call demand energy, but the distribution. So investors should not, you know, bring to us their perceived priority. We know our priorities and we need to stand up, and members of parliament are good at this. We need to stand up and say our current energy gap is this. Otherwise, some of these agreements dictate that the investors prioritize, and you know their priorities are based on the profits from what they intend to do.
Chiboga Woman MP and a Member of Parliament on Committee on Natural Resources and Environment Committee agrees that there is need for reforms to protect the human rights of Ugandans working in these industries. Story by Aloysius Kasoma for the news.